einen du Sonnenschein und damit dir im Wald allein. Weiter brauch ich nicht so glücklich sein, Wochenend und Sonnenschein.
Greetings, YouTube misfits, miscreants, malcontents, and misanthropes. Claire's here with her coffee. Come on in, grab yourself a cup. We're going to talk about YouTube and YouTubers. For those of you who say they haven't seen the other fat ass cat, here she is, and she hates being on camera. It's been another peaceful week here in Soggy Bottom, but we are enduring the last hot spell, hopefully, of our summer. I'm keeping a careful eye on the tropical depression out in the Atlantic that may develop into a hurricane and may come this way. You may have noticed that I uploaded a couple of very short videos. I'm experimenting with that as a method, that is doing very, very short, tightly edited videos, and I hope you found them amusing. Some of you are concerned that I'm going to be quote mined on the transitional fossil video. Who cares? Creatards are going to do what creatards do, no matter what you say, so we may as well have a little fun. Of course, my other short video was having a little bit of fun with Governor Goodhair, Rick Perry. He's an easy target because, well, he's a dumbass, and being a dumbass running for president, he never shuts up. So I'm sure there are going to be more Governor Goodhair videos down the road. Now, I must admit, there I mine the rich seam that is the collected works of the late Molly Ivins. And I gotta tell you, I miss that lady mightily. But that's enough blather about me and my videos. Let's talk about a couple of shout-outs today. There are some young guys who have been entertaining me mightily. They don't have a great following on YouTube. The first of them is Bob's Mirfak, who's only produced a few videos, but it's a terrific series called Your Bible on Psychotherapy.
This is your Bible. This is your Bible on psychotherapy. There came forth little children out of the city, and mocked him, and said unto him, Go up, thou bald head, go up, thou bald head. And he turned back, and looked on them, and cursed them in the name of the Lord. And there came forth two she-bears out of the wood, and tare 42 children of them. And he went from thence to... And there came forth an angel of the Lord out of the wood, who said, What are you thinking? And Elisha enrolled in an anger management seminar and took a hard look at his insecurities.
I simply can't do comic justice to Bob's Mirfak videos in a brief clip. You're just going to have to go look at them. Now, the second guy I want to do a shout out for is a young fella named One McKinley, who does something called the 1 Minute News.
Kate Winslet has managed to rally her friends Emma Thompson and Rachel Vice to come out against plastic surgery and other cosmetic procedures. They call themselves the British Anti-Cosmetic Surgery League, which sounds very British indeed, and they claim they will never fall to the pressures Hollywood places on actresses to get facelifts, boob jobs, or Botox. 52-year-old Emma Thompson has been quoted as saying,
I'm not fiddling about with myself. We're in this awful youth-driven thing now where everybody needs to look 30 at 60.
What? That's how she sounds. At any rate, hopefully this sparks a movement before everyone in Tinseltown looks like Joan Van Ark. Yeah, get thee to thine crypt, demon!
There are people on YouTube who are funny because, well, they're trying to be funny. There are other people on YouTube who, they're just funny. And I mean that in the old Southern sense. This week I suffered an embarrassment of riches in terms of potential dim bulbs of the week. I finally decided to limit it to two nominees, and these nominees rose head and shoulders above all others. There are videos on YouTube that simply leave one astonished at the sheer mind-boggling, jaw-dropping ignorance and cluelessness of the provider.
One missing link that I've not being able to find, for instance, and that's the missing link between the thylacine and the gray wolf. The thylacine, it was a type of canine that lived, that was indigenous of Australia.
FYI viewers, the last thylacine died in an Australian zoo in the 1930s.
And the evolutionists say, well, it's part of the evolutionary process between, it's part of the evolutionary process of the gray wolf.
No, Ron. No biologist has suggested that thylacines and gray wolves were closely related or that one evolved into the other. You've wholly misunderstood the term convergent evolution.
The term convergent evolution. Those two canines really don't look very much alike. I mean, they're both canines. It's obvious they're both canines.
Ron, thylacines weren't canines. They didn't belong to the canidae. They weren't even placental mammals. They were marsupials. And therefore, they were more closely related to opossums and wallabies than to gray wolves.
The idea that they are evolved, one is evolved from the other, is ridiculous.
It sure is. Fortunately, no one's suggested that. Maybe I should explain the term convergent evolution. Convergent evolution refers to organisms that, although they aren't closely related, they've evolved to, at least externally, look very much like each other. The reason is that they have evolved to occupy similar ecological niches. And sometimes the external appearance can be remarkably similar. For example, here are three large predators that strongly resemble one another and all look like felines. In fact, only one is a cat. The Smilodon in the upper left was a large predator that once lived in North America. Thylacosmilus on the right was in fact a marsupial, and it once lived in South America. Thylacoleo on the bottom once lived in Australia, and it is also a marsupial. Our next candidate created all manner of hell this week and probably caught a lot of crap because of her clueless video concerning race.
I kind of enjoy discussing this, and not because it's offensive by nature, but because, well, we've made it so, but I intend to change that, and I'm not afraid of a label, and it, you may not like it, but it's not hate speech, and it's not an appeal to authority. So you say that races don't exist, and that, or races are all the same and equal, and that individuals are all equal. How can you say that? It's not just skin deep, it's genetic, it's ingrained in our biology. And why is it bad only when a person of white origin chooses to speak of it, keeping in mind there are those who would choose a very inhumane course of action in the name of their beliefs?
The fundamental question was asked by the YouTube voice of reason, D. Landon Cole.
Ruka, I've got a very simple, short question. What is a race, as you understand it?
I wondered that as well, Landon. For a number of reasons. For one thing, one of the things I do for a living is demography, population statistics. And I know a good deal about the history of demography in the United States. For instance, I know since we began taking a census of population in 1790, the definition of race, as revealed on census forms, has been very mutable. And the concept of race has varied greatly through time in the popular imagination. For example, in the 19th century, many people did not consider the Irish to be white. I also know that there's great genetic diversity among human populations throughout the world. For example, in Africa, there is far more genetic diversity than probably one could find throughout much of the rest of the world. And yet, many people who are wholly ignorant of that fact, would regard most Africans as being of the black race, whatever that may mean. And finally, for anyone who's had a proper course in geography or an opportunity to travel, particularly in Eurasia or Africa, as you move from place to place, appearances of the populations change. But it's a gradual, incremental process. It's not like there's a sharp dividing line and a neat little box that you can take people and put them in, and we call that race. Obviously, we have two massively ignorant candidates for Dim Bulb this week. But of the two, I suspect that Heyruka's views are far more corrosive, far more harmful, potentially more damaging to our society as a whole. Therefore, congratulations, Heyruka. I agree with D-Land & Co. You are a nascent racist.
You know, you really are an asshole.
Why don't you just shut up and sing the song, pal?
I'm an asshole, yo, 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 yo. I'm an asshole.
Oh, crap. I ran long again. I gotta get out of here. Besides, I have to go cry my beer after Wolves handed Fulham their ass today. You have a sweet week anyhow. Bish Beto.